man is the son of God, and thus God has natural dominion over the human race. The abusive perversion of distorted minds leads to oppressive dominion of man over man. The weak are made to serve the strong, and their lives are made bitter with hard bondage. Thus, the birth of slavery leads to the death of freedom. The history of the modern world is a history of wars and revolutions. Even the 20th century has seen over 10 revolutions. The Russian, the French, the German, to name a few.
Even India wasn't spared. Her people were under foreign subjugation for over 1,000 years. British subjugation led to loss of political, social and religious freedom. Mahatma Gandhi led the masses to political emancipation from British autocracy.
Bharat Mata Ki Jai! Vande Mataram! Vande Mataram! Bharat Mata Ki Jai!
It was in the early 17th century that some 20 million Africans were brought to America and traded for crops. That marked the beginning of the dark period in American history, wherein the African Americans were seen as commodities. They had no legal rights and were treated as livestock. After the Second World War, African Americans worked harder than ever in the struggle for dignity and equality. Leaders like Martin Luther King Jr.
I am happy to join with you today in what will go down in history as the greatest demonstration for freedom in the history of our nation.
Among the millions of young minds that were stirred by his clarion call, there was one boy of the underprivileged Afro-American origin from a village in Cleveland, Ohio. His name, John Favors.
Dr. King, I would like you to meet this young man, John Favors, from Rawlings Junior High School.
Hello, Dr. King. Glad to meet you, sir.
He's one of our boys chosen for the Upward Bounce program.
Mr. Osborne, isn't it the program for gifted kids from lower-income homes to enable them to move ahead and prepare for higher education?
Yes. And John Favors has the intellect, enthusiasm and determination to do it. He's truly exceptional, Dr. King.
Congratulations, Mr. Favors. I appreciate it.
Thank you, sir. I'm interested in really making something of myself, for my family, for my people. Dr. King, why don't you use the word black instead of negro? And why do you wear a Western dress rather than a dashiki?
John, are you challenging Dr. King? Most people are just happy meeting Dr. King.
Who are you, young man? What have you done for your people? Who have you liberated lately? Did you notice how he strutted all the way up to the time that he was ready to take me on? He spoke like a true leader. You know, Mr. Osborne, this young man is headed somewhere. He is at least 10 years ahead of his time.
Thus, a great visionary leader spotted in this young Johnny boy, as his mother lovingly called him. A global leader who would lead the people towards the highest freedom of the soul from perpetual bondage.
John's story begins in Cleveland, in the Favors household in 1950. Destiny was bleak for the blacks in the ghettos of Cleveland. Despite childhood playfulness, John's godly heart was drawn into becoming a child evangelist. He took life seriously and was determined to excel in whatever he put his mind into. His sharp academic intellect soon won him a full scholarship into the prestigious Princeton University. The Princeton campus began to shape his worldview, which he tried to comprehend through metaphysics, political sciences, psychology, and Eastern mysticism. His burning interest in yoga found him pursuing teachers of various traditions. One such guru was Norman Anderson.
Norman, you were never going to guess what just happened to me today. The most important event in my life. I can't believe it.
You met your guru today, and you have taken initiation from him.
Oh, Norman, he was so brilliant. How could you guess that?
One need not possess the highest level of intelligence to guess that, John. The last time I saw you so excited was also for the same thing.
Oh, this time is not like the previous times, Norman. I thought you'd be proud of me.
I can see that this teacher of yours has only a little impersonal realization at best. And it is not what you are thinking about.
You know, Norman, how deeply I respect you. So if you denounce this guru, I will denounce him too.
It was my grandmother, hailing from the holy land of India, who introduced me to the Vedic teachings. You know me well, John. Although my personal inclination is towards Islam and mysticism, I save talking about Krishna, the blue dude who is God, to my bright students like you.
I do understand that well enough, Norman. You are a pipe piper for us, young black soul searchers in particular. Why do you not initiate me as your disciple? I want you as my guru.
No, John, no. I am not your actual guru.
But why not? Norman, why not?
Do you really want to know who is your real guru? Your life will probably have to change after hearing this truth forever.
Well, yes. Yes, please tell me, Norman. Please tell me.
The spiritual master of the Hare Krishna movement, BhaktiTirtha Swami Srila Prabhupada, he is the real Jagat Guru, the Guru of the whole world.
What? That Hare Krishna?
Thus, the Prince of Princeton wholeheartedly surrendered to Srila Prabhupada, the King of Devotion, who had brought the matchless gift of Bhakti Yoga to the Western world, and became his duly initiated disciple, Ghanshyam Das.
Ghanshyam?
Oh, Satswarup Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances.
Prabhu, did you see Ghanshyam anywhere?
Maharaj, he must be chanting his daily 42 rounds somewhere against the wall.
He's really a Vyartha Kalatvam. Never wastes a single moment without serving Krishna. It's humbling to see him outdo all of us at every level. His enthusiasm, his taste for the holy name, his austerity, his Sankirtan scores, everything.
You bet it, Maharaj. He sleeps hardly 3 to 4 hours a day. And what to talk of his prasad? He eats only once a day, and that too only some fruit or little juice. He has conquered his jivavegam completely, Maharaj.
So maybe eventually he'll make disciples all over the world. Sarvam apimam prithvim sashishya.
Please accept my obeisances, Satsarup Maharaj.
There you are, Ghanshyam.
I heard you're looking for me.
Oh, yes, yes.
How can I serve you, Maharaj?
Ghanshyam, you're very good at distributing Prabhupada's books to anyone and everyone. You're always elegant and persuasive, and people really like you. I was just thinking, it would be really nice if you can expand the Sankirtan program from the streets to include selling Srila Prabhupada's books to all the famous university libraries. Why don't you form a library party for this?
Wow! A library party? Amazing!
Yes, a library party. Yes! After all, what is a university library without Prabhupada's books? Raja Vidya, Raja Gaiham. Library party! Yes, that's it!
Good evening. Good afternoon.
You mean good morning?
Sorry. Good morning, sir.
Yes.
Professor Dostoevsky, I have an appointment with you, sir.
With me? No, I don't have any appointments today.
No, sir. I think there is some miscommunication.
Here is my list of appointments for this week.
You can kindly check with your secretary, sir.
But she's on pregnancy leave for the last 1 month, my friend. Just for your information.
Oh, how wonderful. But I have traveled 4 hours to have an audience with you. So if you don't mind, can I explain the purpose of my visit anyways?
Well, I'm afraid I just have a class in the next 10 minutes, so I guess I should be leaving now.
10 minutes, enough time for me.
Well, then your time starts now.
And thank you, Professor. I'm Ghanshyam, the official promotional representative for Bhakti Vedant Book Trust. This is the largest publication house on ancient Eastern texts, and literally millions are reading these invaluable pieces of literature all over the world.
Oh, really? all over the world, is it?
Yeah. They are available in all major languages. Essentially speaking, the author Bhaktivedanta Swami, who is Sanskrit scholar and master of Oriental philosophy, is the first time exposing the world to the timeless wisdom of Vedas.
The Vedas?
Yes, sir. These books also talk about the oldest political system of governance, the sociological structure of society for harmonious living. It talks about the historical facts beyond the reach of modern Indologists. You know, sir, it also talks on the structure of atom and the creation of universe, which you know is a big question in scientific circles.
The book seems to be talking about everything.
Yes, sir. Therefore, they are the essence of Vedanta, the end of knowledge.
But Mr. Ghanshyam...
Yes, Ghanshyam.
Where are these books, anyways?
Actually, sir, the author has completed about 3/4 of his monumental work, and he sleeps only 3 to 4 hours to complete the rest. So we are now taking on his standing order, sir. I was wondering if, like all major universities of Europe and America, even you would like to have a set of books for your university library?
Oh, yes, why not? It would be my honor to have such a priceless literature in our library.
Would you also like a personal set of books for yourself?
That's a good idea also. I can have it.
Thank you, sir. Please sign this form, Professor. And we shall work out the details with your secretary. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your given time.
Thank you, Mr. Ghanshyam. You're doing a great job. Wish you all the best, son.
Thank you.
That was Ghanshyam's potency. He was just amazing. To this day, Krishna devotees work hard to distribute books. Their goal is to live the books, not just to give them away. Ghanshyam excelled at both.
Srila Prabhupada, there is a letter from Ghanshyam.
Oh, Ghanshyam, what is the news of the library party? I always feel encouraged by his book scores.
Prabhupada, they have lately been distributing books across the Scandinavian countries, Denmark, Finland, and others. Not only that, Prabhupada, he has also met a well-known psychologist at Harvard University who showed keen interest in your books.
This devotee Ghanshyam is amazingly empowered. Jai.
September 1977, Srila Prabhupada's health had deteriorated considerably. In spite of failing health, Srila Prabhupada, in the mood of a relentless soldier, made his arduous journey to London to reciprocate with the love and service of his devotees.
Oh, so here is the team from Eastern Europe. Welcome, Ghanshyam, welcome. Hari Bol, Krishna Kshetra. Nice to see you, Prabhu. You guys drove a long way to Bhaktivedanta Manor.
Prabhupada has traveled so far from India to inspire us. How could we not come here to see him and reciprocate with his unconditional spiritual love for us?
We heard that his body is giving away. There is only a thin layer of skin covering his bones.
That's true. But hey Ghanshyam, Srila Prabhupada would be very happy to see you. Your presence will be like tonic for Srila Prabhupada's ailing body. Even though he has stopped eating or drinking, but your book's course are like a life-giving elixir. Come on, let me take you to him. Srila Prabhupada, here is Ghanshyam, your veteran book distributor. He is here to have your darshan.
Jai. Your life is successful. Thank you very much. This is Parampara system, wherein a disciple follows in the mood of a teacher. My Guru Maharaj pushed me, I am pushing you, and you are pushing others to spread the mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Jai.
Prabhupada, Prabhupada.
With the departure of Srila Prabhupada in November 1977, Ghanashyam took solace in his services by increasing his commitment to the mission in unprecedented ways. Part of this was taking sannyas. He was now to be known as BhaktiTirtha Swami Maharaj.
In a mystical dream, Srila Prabhupada seemed to indicate that BhaktiTirtha Swami now utilizes African ancestry to expand and revolutionize his preaching in Africa. Africa was a dangerous and difficult preaching terrain with numerous challenges, wherein formerly Brahmanand and Pushtakrishna Maharajas had entered like a needle. BhaktiTirtha Swami would now transform it into a flower.
Well, so here we go, folks. We have with us once again Swami Krishnapad on our evening show today. Let us welcome BhaktiTirtha Swami.
It's sure is my pleasure.
Swamiji, I have to tell you that you're clearly a man of God. What fascinates me most about you is your influence and knowledge. How it is not limited to your own traditions. I mean, you're well-versed in so many areas from so many perspectives. Your knowledge, your compassion, and love for your own fellow men and women transcend not only religious boundaries, but also cultural boundaries. How do you do that?
Well, we try to teach those who are interested. These teachings from the East, somehow blending it with our Western outlook so that they are more acceptable for even me. We now have this institute called the IFAST, the Institute for Applied Spiritual Technology.
IFAST! That's a nice one.
Yeah. Spiritual life is an urgent necessity for all living beings. We should be aware that any day could be our last day on earth.
Mm-hmm.
So we shouldn't waste any time. We are on borrowed time. That's why IFAST.
That's interesting, Swamiji. Tell us more about it.
IFAST will attract people from all different religions. New Age, Buddhist, Christian, Muslim, Hindu, and others.
Wow.
Everyone is challenged to become a serious and dedicated practitioner, no matter what his or her professed faith. The purpose of this institute is to conduct seminars wherein members of one community can assist in each other's spiritual development by sharing God-centered techniques and principles that we can use in our daily lives.
Mm-hmm. Whoa, that sounds brilliant, Swamiji.
We constantly look at problems facing human society, individuals, corporations, institutions. We all just give people only knowledge without an environment to activate that.
Mm-hmm.
Then it is only wishful thinking. Actually, people are in disharmony with themselves, and therefore we need to create leaders who are willing to lead by higher principles.
Uh-huh. Swamiji, you are a spiritual leader, a social reformer, and you are also an author of many books such as The Spiritual Warrior, The Beggar Series, and Reflections, just to name a few, you know. Tell us something about The Spiritual Warrior. I mean, that is indeed a fascinating name practically for any book.
Yeah.
The Spiritual Warrior explores the use of spiritual weapons like prayers, inner discipline, meditation, etc. to combat debilitating plagues like depression, anxieties, hopelessness, which are all endemic in this modern world.
Mm-hmm.
And the bigger series explains how virtues like patience, humility, love and compassion can be useful tools to combat conflicts and stress at individual and collective levels in society.
Wow.
In this way, he was regularly on TV and radio shows. He was regularly meeting with celebrities, leaders of states, and national leaders, and giving them valuable spiritual inputs, both on personal and national level.
Hello, Swami. I am Flight Lieutenant J.J. Rawlings.
Maharaj, he was the former head of state for Ghana.
I was enthralled to view your interview on the national TV the other day, Swami. And I demanded a personal copy of the video to keep at home.
Happy and grateful to meet you, sir.
Thank you. The pleasure is mine.
I think we have a joint responsibility to bring about a change. A permanent change in the human society, considering that we are faced with so many challenges.
Maharaj, our High Court Judge Mr. Ayyadurai Shivanandan has come to see you. He has taken to Krishna consciousness like a fish takes to water.
Very happy to meet you again, sir.
Maharaj, he is such a respectable High Court Judge in Zambia. You will be delighted to know that he wears Vaishnav Tilak while in the courtroom.
Gurudev, he is also reading your books regularly.
Swamiji, your preaching has convinced me about Krishna consciousness. That is the only true way of living for every human being.
Royals of great cultural heritage eagerly received him, anxious to hear his enlightening words and nourish their souls in his association. He was invited for a presidential dinner with the president of Zambia, Mr. Kenneth David Konda.
Thank you, Mr. Konda, for this exotic vegetarian feast. Very thoughtful of you, sir.
I have myself been vegetarian for many years now.
Of course. You're known as the Gandhi of Africa. Ahimsa. So Maharaj, you were speaking about leadership.
Yes. As I was explaining, a powerful leader is a bridge between his people and God. The art, the trick, the technique is to apply the most ancient teachings on the planet and their wisdom to adapt to modern contemporary situation.
Maharaj, His Excellency wanted to know how would the ancient Vedic wisdom help to solve the raging problems of AIDS in Africa? It has reached unmanageable proportions.
Swamiji, is there any Vedic solution to this problem?
Every material problem has a metaphysical and most importantly, a spiritual counterpart.
He was thus unquestionably at the helm of affairs in Africa, expanding Krishna consciousness in incredible ways.
So to conclude this memorable event, we would like to thank our special dignitaries, His Holiness BhaktiTirtha Swami, and our dear national hero, Mr. Nelson Mandela.
Swamiji, I want to congratulate you and your wonderful team for your selfless work in Africa. You're distributing food to the flood victims through your Food for Life program, to the KwaZulus in South Africa, then your Book for Africa program, and I was even told about your Stop Raping Our Children campaign. And that's just to name a few. Swamiji, you're indeed a creative genius.
Mr. Nelson Mandela, indeed you have done a monumental work in freeing our oppressed African people from the shackles of racial discrimination.
No, Swamiji. You are a champion of the downtrodden. Through your universal and non-sectarian message, you are fanning the flame for love and service to God. That's a much higher achievement, Swamiji.
They all saw him as their natural leader. In fact, his compassion, love, and determined preaching fetched him the highest civilian honor conferred upon him by the Wari people in Nigeria.
I, as the Oroje of this Wari tribe, am honored to hereby coronate His Holiness BhaktiTirtha Swami as the honorary High Chief of our Wari Kingdom. Maharaj is a true warrior because he worked very, very hard to help
our African people, as only a true African king would do. Aram Wakpo!
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 He is a conqueror, a true hero. Thank you, Swamiji. Now, please come and accept this.
Respected dignitaries, the Oroze and friends, I am honored and grateful to get this rare recognition. Within my heart, I am accepting this crown on behalf of my beloved spiritual master, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. He is a spiritual ambassador who brought the Vedic knowledge to the West. Actually, he is the true High Chief.
Amen! Now, let us celebrate in your Hare Krishna style, Swamiji.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.
This was an event of colossal significance. Krishna consciousness was taking over Africa, and BhaktiTirtha Maharaj was clearly leading the way. With his charismatic smile, his gracious dancing, his immense knowledge, fierce determination, and dynamic exuberance, he ignited the fire of the Hare Krishna explosion in Africa. Everywhere BhaktiTirtha Swami traveled, around the world, his life-altering kirtans and his dancing were a trademark. Something that people would look forward to.
As BhaktiTirtha Maharaj became a well-known international leader with numerous preaching engagements lined up for years to come, the ravages of time manifested in unexpected ways, changing his plans forever. In 2004, he was diagnosed with fourth stage malignant melanoma on his left foot. He tried various therapies from the best cancer hospitals and alternative care centers in Mexico, Arizona, and Hawaii, but to no avail. At last, the only option remained: amputation of his left leg.
All the devotees, please do not crowd around Maharaj. Kindly go and sit into the temple room. Gurudev will address all of us there.
Make way.
Move, Prabhus, please get aside. Please, move.
What a sacrifice. The most divine dancing leg of our dear Gurudev. Being cut by a surgeon, sir.
Please take care of her, Vraja Leela. She is very dear to me.
His Holiness BhaktiTirtha Swami Maharaj ki
Jai!
Radhanath Swami Maharaj ki Jai!
Jai!
Gurudev, we are praying for you.
I thank you all for coming and praying for me. Your prayers are received. They are in storage.
The amount of love emanating from you is so overwhelming, Gurudev. It is almost painful.
I am grateful to Krishna for giving me this cancer, because people and devotees come to me with such sympathetic open hearts, and I am able to counsel them and enter right into their hearts and help transform them in ways that I could never do before. I think this whole cancer incident is a great benediction. A very great benediction indeed. All my life I tried to model it around the life of Vasudev Datta. I pray that all the karmic obstacles come upon me so that the devotees can chant, dance and be happy and go back to Godhead. let me suffer on their behalf. Please know, when I return home up there, I will make arrangements for all of you there. That would be my service even after I die. You can never get rid of me. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Death, an eternal mystery for the common man. But luminaries like BhaktiTirtha Swami, who are emissaries of the divine, live in this world like the lotus flower, forever untouched by the quicksand of time.
Please hold my shoulder, Maharaj.
Maharaj, it's time for your medicines now.
Thank you, Brajalila, for all your care.
Are you comfortable, Gurudev? How is your pain after the injection?
By Krishna's mercy, it is little better, Ekavira.
Ah, Radhana Swami, please come, please come. Gurudev, Radhana Swami has come to take your leave to go to New Vrindavan.
Do you really have to leave, Maharaj? I have a desire. I would like to request you to stay with me till I depart. I want to leave my body in your arms, Maharaj.
But Maharaj, I'm here. As long as you're living in this body, I'm here with you. It's the greatest honor of my life to be here with you. There is nothing in the 14 worlds that I can do to please Srila Prabhupada more than being here in your service. There's nothing else Prabhupada would want me to do.
Die before you die was not just a theoretical ideology for this spiritual warrior, but a moment-to-moment reality. In the days that followed, their exchanges became more intimate and deeper. He especially wanted to focus his mind on Vrindavan.
In Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, it describes how when Madhavendra Puri, the greatest of all Vaishnavas, the Param Guru of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, as he was leaving the world, again and again he recited a particular verse. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explained that this is crestual of verses. As Kostubamani is the most precious of all jewels, this verse is the crest jewel of mellow prayers. It is explained by Kaviraj Goswami that there are only three people who could understand the inner meaning of this prayer in full. One is Srimati Radharani. The other is Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is Krishna with the Mahabhav of Srimati Radharani. Third is Madhavendra Puri. That is Madhavendra Puri's exalted position. By his example, he taught all of us the perfection of leaving one's body in the spirit of love and separation. Let us sing our theme song. Oh my Lord!
Oh my Lord!
Oh most merciful Master!
Oh, most merciful Master!
O Master of Mathura!
O Master of Mathura!
When shall I see you again?
When shall I see you again?
Because of my not seeing you.
Because of my not seeing you.
My agitated heart has become unsteady.
My agitated heart has become unsteady.
Oh, most beloved one.
Oh, most beloved one.
What shall I do now?
What shall I do now? Amazing! Amazing! We are there, Maharaj. We are there.
Where are we, Maharaj? Where?
In Vrindavan. We are in Vrindavan now, Maharaj. We are in Vrindavan.
Earlier, BhaktiTirtha Swami had declined giving up his body in Mayapur or Vrindavan. To make a strong statement that each of Prabhupada's ISKCON centers in the world are holy dhams, non-different from Vrindavan. Now, in a most mystical way, Krishna was reciprocating with Maharaj's mood of separation by sending Panditji, Narsingh Baba and Madan Mohanji, all pure-hearted Brijvasis from Barsana, all the way to Gita Nagari, Pennsylvania.
Dear Radhanath Swami, you have been such a dear friend. Your blessings of Srila Prabhupada helping me in the final stage of my journey in this world. But I have one more desire. Maharaj, I know about your life. The quest of a spiritual, fearless teenager willing to stake his life to unravel the secrets of life. Maharaj, this is not your story. This is the tale about how God leads a young boy onto an amazing journey to seek the inner secrets that are within all of us. Do not be miserly. Please share what has been given to you. Please promise me, Maharaj, promise me here on my deathbed that you will write your story. This is a dying friend's request.
Maharaj, I am your obedient.
No, Maharaj, I am your obedient.
This is my journey home. My journey home.
For years, the ecstatic dancing and singing of BhaktiTirtha Maharaj was the highlight of the annual New York Jagannath Rath Yatra. But this year, the Lord noted the conspicuous absence of His dear devotee. Thus, the Black Lord appeared in the dream of their pujari to bring them to Gita Nagari all the way from New York and reciprocate with the intense love in separation of the Black Lotus, BhaktiTirtha Maharaj.
I do not have much breath left. This is a beautiful thing. Krishna is letting me know that my time is over. How wonderful this is! How glorious this is! How fortunate we are! Now my chariot is waiting for me. Krishna, I am coming. Krishna.
The life and departure of BhaktiTirtha Maharaj so much resembled the illustrious life of Grandfather Bhishma of the Mahabharata. As the fearless Kuru warrior lay dying in full consciousness on a bed of arrows, great celebrities of universal fame came to seek his blessings and hear him expound on profound spiritual truths. May the ambrosial fragrance of this resplendently smiling black lotus help extricate mortals like us from the rotting stench of material existence and bring us to the eternal garden of love of God.
Jai Jai Radhe Jai Jai Shyam, Jai 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 Vrindavan. Jai Jai Radhe Jai Jai Shyam, Jai 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 Vrindavan. Jai Jai Radhe Jai Jai Shyam. Jai 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 Vrindavan. Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai 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 Vrindavan. Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai 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 Vrindavan. Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai 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 Vrindavan. Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai 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 Vrindavan.
RG Media YouTube channel. Like, share, subscribe.